And any snow they get, it's in and out quick in our area, too. But the problem is, in our area, we could see just a little accumulation, just enough to slow you down. So be careful, especially elevated surfaces, bridges, overpasses, you know, the typical drill. Cloudy and 39, still waiting for the snow to hit the ground. It's falling above the city and some drops falling above the city as well. These are the current temperatures, clearly cold enough in Kingston for snow, 27. You have 32 in Wayne. Problem is, you know, you head out 3, 46, 80, up 17, you head into the elevation. That's where you're gonna see some better chances for a little bit of accumulation as well. Cold in Katona at 33, 39 kind of the hot spot there in the city. So you can see even in the city, you know, as that radar beam goes up into the atmosphere, it's drops, picking up drops here through Queens, and then there's that change over to a little bit of snow up through Bronx, the Bronx and into Westchester, particularly North Westchester. That's where you're going to see a better chance for just enough snow to slow you down. I mean, it's the stuff you slip and slide on. You don't have to shovel it much because there isn't going to be that much to shovel. You can see farther to the west, a little bit of heavier snow that's going to push through. And again, it's mostly a morning event because the wind is going to kind of shred it. And we're going to see that sun come out later today. See the green there, South Jersey, over into parts of Maryland? That's where we're seeing a little bit of mixing as well. So let's time it out for you. Timestamp up here, and you can see between now and, say, 8 or 9 o'clock, these snow showers pushing through, and by then we should see cold enough conditions even in the city for some snow. So yeah, just a kind of a covering of snow in the city. Then in the afternoon, the whole dynamic changes because the wind is reinforced, so you see these widely scattered snow showers, but they could be accompanied by gusty winds, so that's kind of the recipe for a snow squall, and that could limit visibility. As far as totals, the GFS, the most aggressive model with this, half an inch to an inch of accumulation. Again, you have to move it, you got to manage it, you can slip and slide in it, and sometimes you can't see in it. A snow squall, again, remember, that's a burst of snow. Gusty winds accomplish that, but it limits visibility. Not a lot of accumulation, but enough to slow you down. So cautionary this morning as we have these snow showers, and then it's the chill, the big chill, overnight tonight into Thursday, and then for the weekend, make sure you're ready for that. It's going to be even colder. Kind of busy weather all of a sudden. Back to you guys.